described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
New Dimension Media QUESTAR presents Inventions That Shook the World, 1920s.
In modern theaters, it's all about sound. Imagine a monster without a roar or an explosion without a bang. Scenes that once were silent until an ambitious inventor took on Tinseltown. New York, 1920. Silent movies are all the rage, but the stars of the silver screen won't stay silent for long if Lee DeForest has his way. DeForest is already a famous inventor, but not famous enough. He wants to be a household name, just like Thomas Edison.
Film professor Leo Emtiknapp.
He was, shall we say, a unique and difficult individual to work with, to put it mildly.
He had very stormy relationships with his professional associates. He fell out with a lot of them. He was a very, very famous litigator. He would sue anybody and everybody.
He worked best alone. He was a maverick. He certainly looked for ways of doing things that had been rejected by others.
DeForest's biggest success, the Audion tube in 1906, boosted telephone signals and created long-distance calling. But 14 years later, at age 47, he's desperate to come up with a big new idea to keep him in the limelight.
In a recreation,
"That man is so handsome, I can only imagine what he sounds like,"
DeForest overhears in a cinema.
Maybe that's the ticket. Bring sound to the movies. DeForest figures if he could pull that off, he'd be a worldwide sensation.
The Described and Captioned Media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.